Most of these aspects I have discussed in the general anatomy. Okay, so in the general anatomy lecture, kindly refer to it in the nervous system. So in the nervous system class of the general anatomy, I have discussed in detail about this reflex arc and what is the typical spinal nerve, what are the types of neurons, types of axons, how do you classify them, and what is the synapse structure of the synapse, everything. Please refer to the general anatomy class. So here your central nervous system processes the information which you are able to see here. General sensations from the skin, which we have seen. Same way, it also receives special sensations from your special sensory organs, like for example eye, it is shown. You also have ear, then you have the tongue, okay, nose and all. Okay, so viscero sensations, as I told you, sensations from the viscera. Then the motor component, mainly it actually supplies the muscle to bring about the desired movement. Then, as I told you, visceromotor to the cardiac muscle. So this is very specialized type of muscle, and as I told you, it is through the parasympathetic component, it is also innervating the bladder, most of the viscera, except the heart. The heart is a special type of muscle, but here you have the smooth muscles. Okay, so somatomotor is mainly to the muscles and to the glands, blood vessels, and the to the viscera, it is called as the visceromotor. So it also acts in concert with the endocrine system. So the endocrine system secretions and the nervous system acts together in maintaining the internal environment, which is actually called as the homeostasis. So whatever the external environment, whether it is a cold climate or a hot climate, we maintain an internal environment which should be always constant. Now, for example, you know our body temperature should be or should not exceed more than the 98.4 degree Fahrenheit. Then we call it as fever. So our body adjusts mainly, not adjusting, it actually takes part in various mechanisms in maintaining the internal environment. For example, in a very hot climate, what happens is you sweat a lot. Are you able to understand? So this is one of the mechanisms which is called as the homeostasis. So coming to the subdivisions of the nervous system, the nervous system is broadly classified into the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. So the central nervous system mainly constitutes your brain and the spinal cord. Okay, so you are able to see the base of the brain, the cerebrum and the cerebellum and the brain stem, and it continues down as the spinal cord. So a thick long neural tube or a nervous tube, okay, spinal cord, which is approximately 45 centimeters in length. Now the peripheral nervous system is actually serves as a bridge between your brain and or the central nervous system and the external environment.